You have already learned a lot of single variable functions. Functions with S domain, some subset of R, and R as codomain. We are now ready to generalize the concept of a function to so-called vector functions. We will leave the domain as it is, but now our codomain will be some subset of R2 or R3, or even higher if you want. So the outcomes of our vectors functions will be vectors instead of numbers. How does that work? Watch the introduction in this video. So, what's a vector function? A function was some kind of engine over here, but now the engine is called R, boldface R, vector R. Input is some variable T, where the domain is some subset of R, so T is just some number. Then the engine works and spits out some R as function of T, some vector. So the codomain is now some subset of Rn, where n may be 2 or bigger, so R2 or R3 or etc. In our examples, we will usually take R2 or R3. So let's introduce some notation. In the n equals 3 case, R of 3, so our output, will consist of, in this case, 3 components, say F, G, and H. And we can also write this in one line if you use the notation I, J, and K, where I is the vector 1, 0, 0, J, 0, 1, 0, and K, 0, 0, 1. So we can also write our vector function like this. So how does this work? How can we do computations? Let's take, for example, the vector function R of T equals T cubed times I plus the ln of 3 minus T times J plus square root of T times K. So in this case, we can read off what our F, G, and H are. F is T cubed, G equals the ln of 3 minus T, and H of T equals the square root of T. So how do we compute, for example, the R of 1 if our input is T equals 1? Then we just plug in T equals 1 into F, G, and H, and we get 1 cubed equals 1. So we get an I over here. Ln of 3 minus 1 equals the ln of 2, so the ln of 2 times J, and the square root of 1 equals 1, so we get 1 times K. How does it work? For example, if we want to find the domain of such a function, so what functions of T can we plug in? Well, look at F, G, and H again. Well, F is T cubed. We can plug in any T we like. For G, we have the ln of 3 minus T, so there we have to be careful because the argument of the logarithm needs to be positive. So T can be 3 or smaller, because otherwise your argument becomes negative. And the square root of t, there we have to be careful as well. The argument of a square root has to be positive, so t has to be positive as well. So t has to be bigger or equal than 0, and smaller than 3. So our maximal domain will be the interval 0, 3, with 0 included and 3 not. So if you look at a vector function, you just look at the components all the time. Same holds if you look for limit and continuity. If you take limit t to a from R of t, let's take a function of 2 components now to ease the notation a bit. Then you have to take the limit of f times I and limit of g times the vector j. So continuity of a vector function means continuity of its components and vice versa. So the consequence R of t is continuous if and only if both f and g are continuous. So final example, what happens if you take the limit from t to 0 of R of t from the first example? Well, if we take a limit, we have to take the limit of the components of the function. So let's do that. Take the limit from t to 0 of t cubed. No problem there, it's just 0. Take the limit t to 0 from the ln of 3 minus t. Also no problem, you can just plug it in, you get the ln of 3. And take the limit of t to 0 of the square root of t of h. Also no problem, you can just plug in t equals 0, so you get a 0. And then combine everything. Limit t to 0 of the vector function means limit t to 0 of the first component times I, plus limit t to 0 of the second component times j, plus limit t to 0 of the third component times k, which gives you, because there are 0, ln of 3 and 0, ln of 3 times j. So as you see, vector functions, for the moment, just behave like a number of normal functions. So, what's the difference between vector functions from R to R3 and say three normal functions? For now, there's no difference. But this was only the first video on this subject.